Welcome to Portugal. Welcome to the Nefertiti cross visit on water use efficiency.
We are in the middle of the Alentejo region, which is south of Lisbon, where we have indeed really problems regarding water shortage. This region is very hot and very dry, so we need to improve our technologies regarding the use of water.
We will study the water use efficiency in vineyards and olive orchards. We will discuss problems and solutions for the sector.
Farmers now, they have lots of different sources of information that they can use to know when and how much irrigation water they should use in their crops. They can use information coming from soil sensors, for instance. They can use crop sensors that will inform about the water status of the plants, information on the weather and weather forecasts. And they need to put everything together in order to get an irrigation schedule.
Here we are at Casa Relvas, one of the demo farms of our Portuguese water hub.
Olá, bom dia. Meu nome é João Graça. Bem-vindos à Casa Relvas. Casa Relvas have more or less 300 hectares of vineyard. The two most important parameters for us are the soil moisture sensor to evaluate the water in the soil and the water potential to determine the stress in the plant, to understand how we need to manage our plan for water irrigation.
When we arrive here in the office, we have access to the data that we collect. Here we define the sensor that we want, and here we have the graphic of the soil water content during the season. This blue line is the field capacity. The red line is the line that we define that starts the stress in the plant. So we try to irrigate between these two lines.
We have different sensors, plant sensors, soil sensors, but those will provide you with localized information on the monitoring stations. But you also need information on the spatial variation of the crop. For instance, soil electrical conductivity that farmers can use to map the variation of texture of their soils. But they can also use the information from the satellite imagery to characterize the crop variation within the farm. So bringing all this data together and extracting information from all this data, you need support, you need a decision support system. There are many companies in the south of Europe that will provide consultancy in irrigation management in order to optimize the irrigation schedules for the farmers.
Here we are in India to have information about the Alqueva Dam project that is one of the largest reservoirs in Europe and that has provided new possibilities for irrigated agriculture in Alentejo wine region. Herdade, Paço, Conde is one of the largest companies making use of the water provided by Alqueva to produce olive oil and wine.
This is a family business. We have about 3,500 hectares, 2,500 under the irrigation system of Alqueva Dam, and we have about 1,000 hectares of cattle. So in the past, our only production was cereals and cattle. We didn't have any water, and then we started doing some dams where we could manage to get some water from the rains. With these dams, we could start producing some small areas of vineyards and olive trees. 3 years ago, we got here the Alqueva Dam. With the Alqueva Dam, everything changed. So we started having a lot of water and we could starting really producing a lot of quantities in the crops that we had.
Herdade, Paço de Conde is a good example of using novel technologies regarding water use water use management and water reuse at the vineyard and winery.
We have our consulting team that comes from Cotter. It's a Portuguese entity that comes here and sees how we are irrigating. We have also our own winery and crushing mill. And the wastewater from these two pass through a wastewater treatment. Then they go to a plastic dam where they are kept. And in the summer, we irrigate with that water. We use compost, so our organic matter, it's always going up year by year. It will help a lot, saving a lot of water and irrigating much less.
During this cross visit, we saw how a government-funded irrigation scheme can very effectively transform the economy of an area that was traditionally quite poor. And the on-farm irrigation management systems we saw are a textbook example of what can be used to improve irrigation management in numerous types of irrigated agricultural systems.